The Dutch are famous for their storm chase barriers, but how do they really design them? Well, I'm Ad van der Toorn. I'm a lecturer on storm chase barriers here in the Technical University. I want to tell you something about a storm chase barrier, how to design it, and let me sketch a first drawing of the situation. Maybe this is a river with a certain discharge coming from maybe Germany. You have the sea on the other side. There's a certain tide, but of course you have some spring tide over it. And maybe there's some sea level rise in the future, so you have an extra high tide within a few years. Maybe there's some subsidence, so there could be an extra level added to it. And then of course the first question is, do we have a problem if the sea level rises? And we have this situation with dunes on the outside and some dikes on the inside. Maybe this is a city that, like Rotterdam, with a harbor inside and some new harbors outside. If the sea level rises, then of course we have the problem of flooding. So we could have two main options on the macro system level. We could balance them. Maybe we raise the dikes. And of course this is problematic because here you have to raise the dikes in the city. That costs you a lot of more per meter to raise the dikes. And the second option is to build a kind of barrier, which could be open in the normal conditions, but it could be closed if the high tide is there and there is some storm surge as an extra height. If you make a kind of decision about these two options, of course you could find out in cost-benefit analysis that maybe the barrier is the best option. So, because you have to raise a long stretch of dike and you have only to build a small barrier in this situation. If you decide, then you come to the next system level. First you decide on the macro system level, but now you come to the system level, and then the question is, what kind of barrier do you need? And of course you have to think about the vessels which enter the ports in this city, and you have to think about the discharge of this river, and maybe you have to think about the tide which comes in and out and of course gives you a nice environment. So what kind of barriers should we build there? And there are a few options. Build a kind of barrier which looks like the barrier in Rotterdam with two big arms swinging around the vertical X, which has some parking docks where you can maintain them. So they are strong barriers. And proven technology. You have another option, which is more like a simple stretch solution with a rolling door in this direction. There's a kind of recess on the opposite side. So connecting these two sides in times of storm. And we have the other option, which gives the kind of swinging barge door. It swings around one axis, vertical axis, and closes also the river in times of storm. And of course, if you have these three alternatives, you have to work them out. First, you have to work them out on a certain technical level so that you have some idea about the amount of steel and concrete and what the price should be. And then you have to look to other criteria like reliability. So the first variant is a little bit complex because you have to float the barrier, the arms of the barrier up and then swing them in and then lower them down. So this is a complex movement which gives you a low reliability. So reliability is not that high. But of course this is easy to maintain, so it's easy to maintain. If you look to the second option, we have a very simple structure. So that's a plus simple structure. But of course, there's always some negative side. There's a lot of bending moment. If this is, for instance, 300 meter like in Rotterdam, then you have a lot of bending moments in your solution. So the strength of the structure could be a problem. And of course, this swinging door, the third option, it's a simple one because it looks like a very big crude oil carrier, but it has to swing around one point, and of course you have to guide it one by cables, etc., to bring it in the right position. So the swing is a little bit problematic, but it is a simple structure. And of course there are more arguments to give, but at the end you have to make a kind of multi-criteria evaluation with the three variants on one side and some criteria on the other side, which could be reliability, etc. And these are the criteria, and at the end you can give them some grades and end up with one or two favorites which you want to work out with. So that's the way you try to come up with a barrier design. You start at a macro level, then you go to a system level. And at the end, of course, you have to work out all the different details and maybe some elements. And at the end, maybe you can find that you have a wrong solution and you have to go back to and loop around till you found the right solution in all the details. After the first loop, you have a first sketch for your barrier.